There is a concept called as effective rate, effective annual rate. Okay. Try to understand this effective annual rate using, you deposited 100 rupees with a bank, okay, PV is 100, okay, and you want to know how much FV you will get, but the rate that you have deposited is 8% and the frequency of compounding is 1, means annual compounding. So this is no brainer that you are going to get 108. So what is the interest rate you have got? So you have got, if you compute it, let's say we compute periodic rate will be 8% divided by the frequency, and we'll compute FV, which is a periodic rate, comma number of periods, and we are saying the number of years you will keep is 1 year. Just think about it, and the number of period will be number of years into the frequency. And we are saying what will the FV? FV will be, what is the rate? Periodic rate. What is the number of periods? 1. PMT is nothing. PV is 100. Okay. So see, you are getting 108. How do you compute your return? So if you compute the return formula in our whatever the normal thing is this. FV minus PV, final value minus initial value divided by the initial value. So if I compute that way, what is my return coming? 108 minus, okay, minus of, so actually this minus sign is there over there. So we'll take the absolute value of minus 100 divided by the absolute value of minus 100. Okay. So you see it comes as 8%. Okay. This is, there is no surprise because it is only one period compounding. However, if I make it, let's say semi-annual compounding. If the frequency is semi-annual, so what will happen? How much money you will get? You will get 108.16. So see, what is your actual realized return? It is not 8%. Even though the stated rate was 8%, you are getting 8.16%. It is because you are getting more money. It is compounding. Okay. If you make the frequency 4, it will become 8.24. If you make it monthly, it will become 8.3. So the idea is this: as the compounding frequency increases, your actual realized return increases. This return, which we are computing for a period of 1 year, it is called as effective annual rate. So what is effective annual rate? Effective annual rate is the rate which we get after considering the impact of compounding. Okay. Now here we have made this complex formula, and here you have made, you don't have to worry about this. Excel is very, very simple. You have a formula called as effect. See what they're saying? Effect returns the effective annual interest rate. So in case of effect, what you have to provide? It is asking for one nominal rate. What is the nominal rate you are getting? And NPERY. So what is this NPERY? So we have this effect. Nominal rate is the rate which you are having, which is 8%. And what is the NPERY? Number of periods in a year. If you have a semi-annual compounding, you have a number of periods as 2 in a year. So effect 8%, comma number of period in a year. So earlier we got here for 2, 8.16%. We should get the same answer here. See, it is 8.16%. If we make the compounding frequency 4, it will be 8.24%. So we can have the same thing. 8%, when the frequency of compounding is 4, you get 8.243. If we increase the decimal, it will also become 8.243. See, 8.243. Right? So please use effect function to find out the effective annual rate. That is the rate which you actually get, okay, when the compounding happens. Okay. But if I give you opposite, so let's say suppose if I say that there's a product whose effective annual rate is 10% per annum, okay, and the frequency is frequency of compounding is semi-annual. Or we'll make this way. We'll say that there is a product whose effective annual rate is 8.16% per annum and frequency is semi-annual. Find the stated rate. We know from the previous discussion that stated rate will be 8%. But the question is, how do we get it? Okay. In Excel. So in Excel we have, see, when we were computing effective annual rate, we were inputting the nominal rate. But now when we want, when we have the effective rate and we want to get the nominal rate, we have a function nominal. So what is my nominal rate? My nominal rate is 8.16%. And what is my frequency of compounding? 2 times a year. See, it has given you the 8% as the interest rate. If your effective rate is 8.243 and the frequency of compounding is 4, you get this way, 8%, right? So from nominal to effective annual rate, you use the function effect. From effective annual rate to nominal, you use the function nominal. So this was the last item I wanted to discuss, effective annual rate, how you get, and how you get the nominal rate. Okay, right. So in this, we have not covered annuity, we have not covered any periodic payment. It is all about the single sum. You are investing a single sum, you have to understand these timelines. Okay, right. And then, yeah, one more item is there, which is nothing but it is like CAGR, okay, which is compounded average growth rate or compounded annual growth rate. CAGR is actually EAR. Okay, how much is like the effective annual rate you are going to get. So imagine if a company has sales of $5 in year 2008 and sales of $15 in 2019. Okay, you may be interested in what is the rate at which it has grown. That is a CAGR. Okay. So to solve this, it's very simple. You take this as PV and you take this as FV. Obviously with the sign convention kept in mind, and you can compute the rate. So CAGR will nothing be the but the rate. Okay. So we can solve this. We'll say sales in 2008, 5. I'll take as minus 5. Sales in 2019, 15. And we want the rate, and we want the rate. For that, we have to first find out that what is the number of period. So please understand, this number of period calculation can be slightly tricky. See, you started with 2008 sales, assuming this is end. Okay, end sales. So from 2008 to 2009, you have how many years? You have 1 year. Even though there, so how do you get the 1 year? Subtract 9 minus 8, 1 year. So here how many years will be there? 19 minus 8, 11 years will be there. Okay. So many students, like past, I had given this type of problem, they have computed 12 years. No. Always we have to see the gap, how many compounding we have. And this is the way I try to find out. I have 2009 here, minus 8, I get 1. So that is how I will, so 19 minus 8 will be 11. I will have. So we'll put it 11. And we can get the CAGR, which is nothing but the rate. Number of period is 11. No PMT. PV is minus 5 and FD is 15. So 3 times it is becoming in 11 years. How much will be the return? So it is, the sales are growing at a rate of along 10.5%. So if you grow at 10.5% in 11 years, you are making 3 times 3x. So what we have covered today, we have covered how to compute the FV, how to compute the PV, how to compute the rate, how to compute the number of period. Then we saw effective annual rate and we saw nominal rate. And we saw CAGR calculation is nothing but it is the rate calculation. So the assignment number 4 is already uploaded. You can download the files, and these are the items only we have discussed, and then we have discussed about the rounding. Okay. Do you have any question? Okay, guys. So if you do not have any question, what I will do is, like,